to go to school to learn and have a brighter future. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You have heard Zina's speech, and for your information, Zina comes from a family of 9 children, and she's 11 years old, but she only started to go to school last year, April. That means she has only been in school for 14 months. So tonight you are able to see her coming up here to give a speech in English. That is a great progress in her life. So it's children like this that we are helping. Our center is called the Divira Child Care Center, right? And it was started with the objective of breaking the cycle of poverty through quality education. Both my husband and I are former teachers. We were trained to teach secondary school. It's about 10 years ago that we started to gather some children who are in primary 6, thinking that they have to face exam. So we started to gather them, try to help them to prepare them for the exam. But we realized that it was too late. Imagine helping children who have gone through 6 years of primary education but still do not recognize alphabets, do not know how to read and write, and they just barely know addition. How to help children like this to pass exam? So my husband and I decided that we have to start from primary 1. So the following year, we took in children from primary 1. We thought that by then we would be able to help them to face 4 years better. But to our surprise, we found that it was too late also. Because a lot of these children don't have the chance to go to preschool. So when they go to primary 1, they are still struggling with alphabets and 1, 2, 3. Whereas the other children in school are already writing sentences. So we realized that if we really want to help children for the low-income group of the underprivileged children, we have to start from preschool. But that remained a dream for about 10 years because I was too comfortable in life that I did not step out of my comfort zone. But about 2 years ago, we started to take in 5 children from a family of 9 to our home to teach them and also to cook them a proper meal because they do not have a proper meal at home. And then later on, friends from KL or Harvest Center started to provide us with materials and training, and that's how this center started about 2 years ago. And in our center, we use the Montessori approach, whereby it's different from the traditional school system in a way that children learn according to their abilities, so that they don't have to compete with their friends and feeling discouraged because they are not as good as your friends and they give up and things like that. At the moment, we have 34 children of various races and various religious backgrounds. And we have a similar center in another village, and this center also was started about 2 years ago, and last week we had the joy of graduating 2 of the children. They have finished their the preschool course and they are going into primary 1. And it's our great joy to be able to help the children and to see them progress. This year we are happy to hear that some of the children actually come and tell us that their school teachers, some of them do go to the regular school, and the school teachers said that they have improved in their schoolwork, and we are happy for them for that. And tonight I just want to say a big thank you to each and every one of you for coming all the way, far, near and far. And thank you very much for your generous donation. Your donation will help many more children like Zina. And we are planning to start another center next year so that more children could be helped. And also tonight I'd like to just specially thank my good friend, Yung Boy. Hey, Yung Boy. Thank you for blessing the children. Thank you for putting all this together. She had worked so hard. She had had sleepless nights. And we learn, I would like to ask one of my children to present her a gift. Thank you.
All right, let's give Ukraine a big round of applause. Doesn't that make a tear in your eyes? All right. Okay.